Coming up on this episode of Swing Nation, we've got an interview with the amazing Rusty Frank. We've got one of our own writing a dissertation about the Savoy Ballroom. And the winners of the Jazz Dance Film Festival. Swing Nation, episode 59, starts now.
Hit that jive, close the door, get the carpet off the floor. Swing Nation.
People grooving together.
Truck on down, pimp your stroll, put some jelly on that roll. Swing Nation.
People grooving together.
Hello, once again, welcome to Swing Nation, episode 59 for October 1st. Happy October, ladies and gentlemen. Get your Halloween outfits ready.
Oh my gosh.
Oh man, already? It's all ready?
That's right. Oh. We're getting, that's a little crazy, right? A little cray cray.
I wanted to be Lulu and Stitch with Carl, but he said no.
Oh!
Wait, who's going to be Stitch?
Undetermined.
Okay. That's very important information. Okay.
It could be either of us.
It could. I think you should be Stitch, definitely.
Yeah. I'm in.
That's Rick-O-Matic, that's Zucker Punch,
Stitch.
This is Spuds. Stitcher Punch. Let's get rolling into some stuff, ladies and gentlemen. We got some quick bits. So,
That's right. We're on our game now.
We can't mention the shit every time. We got to do it and just like act like it didn't happen. Sorry.
Fine.
Season
six.
Yes.
Here's a thing that happened during the summer. Well, actually just happened about a month ago or whatever. AGT, America's Got Talent. I'm sitting on the couch watching
AGT?
It. AGT? Yeah, I watch it.
Sweet
wow.
I watch AGT, girl,
wow,
friend.
Right.
I watch
right.
it. I'm sorry. I'm a sucker. I fell into it. I got to see my Mel B. My Mel B, you know.
Who?
Off the chain. Anyway.
I have no idea what he just said.
Yeah, you got to be an AGT watcher. But check this out. I'm watching America's Got Talent. I see.
AGT.
I see a couple of cats on there that I think I know. And it's Kieran and Finney and Makepeace. And I go, Kieran and Finney and Makepeace. Wait a minute. Kieran and Finney and Makepeace, the Makepeace brothers.
Okay.
One of those guys is a Lindy Hopper, or was a Lindy Hopper,
mm-hmm.
Finian, with the Minnie's Moochers.
He was a moocher.
He was a Minnie's moocher.
No relation to William Makepeace Thackeray?
No relation, sorry. But so they made it past finals, they made it through the prelims and the mm-hmm. semi. They got to New York City, they actually performed at Radio City Music Hall.
They're not dancing.
No, they're not dancing. That's true. They are a band. They both play multiple instruments. Check this clip out. This is from AGT.
Are they a band of brothers?
They're a couple of brothers. They're a band of brothers. That's Kieran on guitar. And Finian is back there on the drums. Oh, sorry, and piano.
He's wailing on those drums.
No, I'm not keeping now the strength I need to push me. You show the lights that stop me.
And that's Howie Mandel. Light a match. So that actually gets a little bigger. It gets a little larger.
That was good.
Yeah, they didn't make it past that round. Competition gets really, really heavy. But I gotta say, Finian, holy crap! I haven't seen him in years.
Yeah.
Last time I saw him, he was hanging out on the campus of what's the college? City College.
Okay.
He used to hang out up there.
Sure.
Anyway, in case you don't remember who Finian is.
This is all to say that Manu's old.
Well, that's... Yeah.
I have to say I don't remember really specifically which one was Finian. So.
Okay, let's take a look. This one is Finian, I think, at Swing Out New Hampshire back in 2000, 2001. This is Finian and Ramona.
All I want, Oh, that guy.
Yeah, Mona. This is the very stylistic kind of Minnie's Moochers.
Classic, sort of.
It's like a classic Moochers kind of routine where they took Lindy and just did whatever they wanted, basically.
Aww.
You remember him now?
Yes.
Nicole, you're not familiar with Finian?
Nope.
But you're familiar with the Moochers, maybe?
Yep.
Okay, cool. Anyway, congratulations, Finn. Keep up the good work. If anybody knows where he is, let us know, because we'll interview him.
We'll interview anyone.
We'll interview anyone. Look at this show. No, actually, we've got a great interview coming up. So
we do.
Who wants to do this one?
Here, I can do this one. So. Okay. As was announced at Frankie 100, every year there's not going to be another Frankie 101, Frankie 102, but there will be some kind of commemoration of World Lindy Hop Day, which happens to be Frankie Manning's birthday.
May 25th.
May 25th. And the idea, I guess, is that every year it will be in a different city to kind of propagate Lindy Hop around the world. And they've announced the first city for the World Lindy Hop Day 2015. It will be Rome, Italy.
It'll be in a boot.
It'll be in a boot. I am super, super excited. It's one of my favorite cities. Wonderful, beautiful city, wonderful people. I personally am very excited to go. So, if you do not have plans, around May 25th, start looking for flights to Italy. It could be a really cool party. I don't know if there's also like a global component to it, or if they mostly want people to go to Italy, but I guess details will be forthcoming, and there's also information on the website if you want to nominate your own city to be the place of World Lindy Hop Day 2016, 2017, 2018, whatever. So it would kind of be like the Olympics, I guess.
My understanding from what I heard at Frankie 100 was that there should be like a strong community global aspect of it, like people participating online in some way, and that
right.
The place where the event is held is really... It's not like the be-all, end-all, like Frankie 95 or Frankie 100. It's like the central hub that coordinates all the global World Lindy Hop Day stuff.
Okay. Well, I'm still going to Italy.
Yeah, that's it. Carl, can we go back to Italy, please?
Carl just said yes, but he's not proposing to you again.
Damn
wow.
It.
I think that's what he said with his eyes. Okay.
All right. Well, next up, one of my dear friends, Alex... I'm sorry, I'm going to butcher your last name. Abdulayev. I think that's
sure.
Right.
Sure.
Better than what I can do.
Fair enough. He lives in Baltimore, and he just finished his PhD in musicology at Boston University. His dissertation is about the Savoy Ballroom and its contributions to jazz music and the development of Lindy Hop. And so he's a fantastic dancer as well as accomplished musician and conductor. You can dance with him in the Mobtown Ballroom in Baltimore. And he's put his whole dissertation online for you guys to read. It's at alexanderabdulayev.com. Mm-hmm. If we can put that up
sure.
there when we're done, then that would be really great so I don't have to spell the whole thing out. But I wanted to give you guys a little bit of a taste of the content of this thing. So his abstract kind of gives you a good indication. He says, from 1926 to 1958, the Savoy Ballroom in New York's Harlem neighborhood, I can speak today, I swear, played a critical role in the development and showcasing of African-American popular culture. During its lifetime, the Savoy Ballroom significantly affected the concurrent development of jazz music and jazz dance and laid important groundwork for racial integration. So just a little guide to the chapters of this. There's 7 chapters of it. And I would love to say, oh, you should read chapter 1 or you should read chapter 2. But when you hear me read what they're about, you'll realize you just have to read the whole thing. Mm-hmm. The first and second chapters of the dissertation address the historical and cultural context of Harlem and the Savoy proper. The third chapter examines some of the emerging traditions behind the Savoy Ballroom status as the world's finest ballroom. The fourth and fifth chapters address the chronological and technical development of music and jazz dance at the Savoy, with particular attention given to the lasting impact of such advancements as the incorporation of swing feel into jazz. And the sixth chapter examines the cultural impact of the ballroom on contemporary and modern media, particularly print, music, film, and photography. And finally, the seventh chapter examines the Savoy Ballroom's participation in the New York World's Fair exhibit in 1939.
Wow.
And the impact on the worldwide export of Harlem's African-American culture. So this is pretty jam-packed with awesome stuff that I feel like you guys in particular, us in particular, are like particularly interested in. So you can go check it out on his website and read it for free because he's awesome. And he said that we can totally poke fun at him on the show if we wanted to about it. So I do have some grammatical notes for you, Alex, which I'll tell you about in person.
Grammatical notes.
Just saying.
He's right. He's got like the definitive dissertation on the Savoy. So if he doesn't quite do the Oxford comma, I'm going to give him a pass.
No, he particularly is not allowed to get a pass in the Oxford comma.
Anyway.
I'm going to take a read. Sounds really cool.
Yeah. Anyway, Alex, baller job.
Thanks
I'm
for
so
sharing your work,
you.
Dude.
Quick bit of feedback. I'll do this really fast. On our YouTube
feedback page.
What am I doing?
Call dance is what you're doing.
Flying. Alexis Strickland asks, can you post a link for the Frankie 100 highlights video? It was so great.
That
was two shows ago.
Yeah.
We tagged it on at the end of our show 57, I think it was. And Elaine Wong, who's the guy who created it, along with some other people, but mostly Elaine. Says, hey Alexis, the official Frankie 100 highlights will be ready soon and will be published on the Frankie Centennial channel here. You will see the link, show up, and go check it out. So thank you, Alain, for doing that once again and also for watching our show.
Yeah.
Paying attention.
Yeah, cool. So if you are new to the Lindy Hop scene or a seasoned professional, there are a few people in the community that you need to know about, and our next guest is definitely one of those people. She's a Lindy Hop dancer, a tap dancer, choreographer, producer, teacher? She's a teether.
She was at one point a teether, I'm sure.
She's a teacher, author, historian. She wrote the book Tap, The Great Tap Dance Stars and Their Stories, 1900 to 1955, produced and directed an all-star tap review called Jazz Tap, featuring Nicholas Brothers and...
Oh, we know those guys.
Savvy and Glover, those guys.
No big deal.
No big deal. And she has toured over 50 European cities as a feature dancer for the big band stage show In the Mood, a tribute to Glenn Miller. Joining us remotely from, are you in Hollywood?
I am in El Segundo, California.
Close enough.
From El Segundo, Hollywood Rusty Frank.
Yay.
Hey, yeah. Rusty.
Nice to be here.
Thank you so much for coming on. This is so exciting to have you on.
I'm really happy to be here.
Yes. Yay. So she is definitely one of our go-to people to talk to. I think I've had her in mind for a couple of seasons, actually, but I think I kind of wanted the show to get better.
Let's be honest. You wanted us to get better.
That's for sure.
How you doing, Rusty?
Really well. Just had a lunch today with Gene Vellos and Hillary Alexander, and we were talking about your show, and we're really excited that you're doing this.
Oh, Nate, she's so good. I love Rusty now.
Well, Hillary and I were both saying that it's really nice that you're introducing us to the younger generation, because we've kind of been here for about 20 years doing our thing, keeping swing dance alive. That's our thing. And it's nice to have you kind of bring that onto the show. So thank you.
Well, speaking of which, so let's get right down to it. So for those who don't know Rusty, why don't you give us a little synopsis of your background in tap and Lindy Hop? I know it's really tough, but
sure. Well, I started dancing when I was 6 years old, and it was tap dancing, and I was a full-on professional tap dancer until 1996 when I was hired by the Stevens Sisters to teach tap dancing at their Swing Camp Catalina. And there I went into the ballroom, and to my amazement, saw about 1,000 Lindy Hoppers. And I just, at that moment, that was it. I just had to do it. So I switched over. I actually moved to London for a couple of years and teamed up with Simon Selman over there. And we did a trade where I taught him tap dancing and he taught me Lindy Hop, and the rest is history. Came back to California, teamed up with Peter Flahiff. We worked together for 5 years, built what's now called Rusty's Rhythm Club and the school Lindy by the Sea. And I've been going great guns since. It's yeah.
Wow.
Man, that's awesome.
And I think that for me, my great passion is twofold. One, building community through Lindy Hop and preserving the dance and the artists who brought the dance to us. People like Gene Bellows and the tap dancers I documented before.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
My passion, make the world a better place through Lindy Hop.
Yeah, actually, while you're talking about it, can you tell us a little bit more about the Gene Bellows campaign? How did you organize it?
Well, I met her in 1996 at Boogie Barons in Germany, and we just hit it off great. She's such a doll. She's so sweet, so soft-spoken, and of course, our idol. So many of us girls, we just idolize her dancing. And she lives like 15 miles away from me, so I came home from that, and I just decided to forge a friendship with her, and did, and then started booking her for some gigs. And when I realized that her 90th birthday was coming up, I thought, this needs to be celebrated. She's alive and she loves to go out and meet Lindy Hoppers. And so I just talked to all these friends of mine who produce big events around the world, like Sing Lim with her C-Jam and Scott Cupid in London and various people, Steve Conrad in Arizona and Sylvia in Italy, and arranged with them to book her for her 90th birthday. So we have 6 gigs this year celebrating Gene 90.
Wow, that is fantastic.
And she's loving it. We've done 3, we have 3 more, and she's just having the best time in the world, really the best. It just, you know, this was something she did a long time ago, these Groovy Movie and Swing Fever, and she entered another world after that swing dance career. She went into ballroom and then came through in Lindy Hop, came back, and everybody started, not everybody, but a few of us started resurging her, and she just couldn't be sweeter about it. She loves it.
So
if anybody out there is interested, just contact me.
Nice.
I have to do my agent. So I'm the Gene Bellows agent if you want to book me as content. I don't know where that person came from.
That was awesome.
That is awesome.
Go ahead, Ray.
So wait, so whose idea was it to get the million views of her 90th birthday jam?
Oh, that was just a really easy thing to do. Actually, one day one of my students contacted me on Facebook and said, have you seen what's happening with the Gene clip? And I said, no, what's going on? And this was a clip that had been posted in March after we came back from Bangkok, teaching there for C-Jam, and in one day it had gone up 100,000 views. And I thought, what is going on? And so I contacted that student. I said, where did you see this? Where did it come to you? And she says, well, my mom sent it to me. And you know that when your mom or your dad sends you the clip that you're in, then you've made it, right? So it turned out that there was a pet blog that posted it. And I tried to contact, it's called Pet Flow. And somehow this one gal on that, it's a pet company, and they post videos that are inspirational, and this gal loved this one and posted it, and it just, within a week, hit 1 million, and it's at 1.5 million now, so we couldn't be happier.
You mean pets as in like 4-legged animals?
Like, come here, buddy, come here, No, he's just sitting down, so, like, this guy.
Oh my god, so cute. I can't handle it.
I guess there's
just have to say that this dog actually came in off the street after living on the street for a year and jumped into my arms while I was teaching a Lindy Hop class. And I have 50 witnesses. The
True
students
story.
Were in class. Yeah. Okay.
That's like my dream. That's all I want in this world. Sweet teaching dance and then a dog just comes flying into my arms and is adorable.
Oh boy.
So new anyway, goal for 2014.
One of the things that's been interesting about the Gene clip going viral is It's now the second most viewed Lindy Hop clip that we've ever had. And I think it represents really well because she's dancing with three fabulous instructors from all over the world, from America, from France, and from Singapore. And it just represents the joy that you can do this at any age with all types of people. It crosses everything. And I think that for me, that's what I love about the dance so much. Every week when I host my swing dance, Rusty's, I look out and I see people of all different ages, all different backgrounds, dancing together with the same, as I call it, the same goofy grin. They're just having a great time. And it's what's magical about our scene.
Exactly. Yeah. Rusty and I were talking, you know, it's really nice that that clip has, let's say it's the United Colors of Benetton of Lindy Hop.
United Colors of the Swing Out. Yeah.
United Colors of the Swing Out.
Yeah.
Let's get back to you for a little bit, Rusty. I have here that you were seen by over 400 bazillion people.
That's the official count.
That's the official count.
Hey, anytime somebody asks you to be Rosie the Riveter in the Rose Parade, the answer is yes.
Yeah, fair enough.
No one asked me.
She was Rosie the Riveter in the...
That's so cool.
In the Rose Parade?
In the Rose Parade.
Man.
How do you get that gig to be like...
Well, I have this friend who's a choreographer. He's not a Lindy Hopper. And he called me and he said, I think you're my go-to person for this gig. I got the opening ceremonies of the Rose Parade. And I need dancers who can do cakewalk, 1920s, Lindy Hop, 1960s. And I say, yeah, I'm your go-to person. So I knew exactly how to get all the dancers. And with the community of dancers here in L.A., it was just so easy to do. And I said, you know, I want to be in the parade too, but I don't want to dance because I had done that before. And in a tap parade, and I had to tap for like 5 miles, and
so
is there anything else can I be on a float or something? And he says, I've already got that picked out. You're going to be Rosie the Riveter. And that was just amazing to be this iconic person, this iconic character in America's history, the We Can Do It person. And I had mentioned this before earlier when we were speaking, Manu, that she was my idol when I was getting through my broken neck. You know, I had to wear that halo, and I couldn't drive, and I couldn't do this, and I couldn't do that. And so my motto, and I actually had it emblazoned on my halo vest, was "We can do it." And that was it. That was my philosophy. We can do it, and it really spills over into, I think, the Lindy Hop world that we do this together. We are together, keeping this thing going. I remember Scott Cupid over in London. Now, one time in 2002, I asked him, "How long do you think we can keep this going?" I said, "How long do you think this swing dance revival will last?" And he looked at me like this and he said, "As long as we want it to."
Wow.
And it was kind of like heavy, deep, that he was right. It's as long as we want it to, we can keep it going.
Aww.
So anybody who's listening out there.
Well, thank you, Rusty. You're definitely been a long time inspiration of mine. It's such a great honor for us to have you on the show. So for those of us who kind of want to keep track of what you're up to and see what you're interested in, how do they reach you? How do they find you?
Okay, I've got a website, rustyfrank.com, and that's got everything about my club, my classes, and also all the tap stuff that I have going. And I still have a lot of DVDs that are available that are tap preservation DVDs, and they're instructional and tell you all about the history of the individuals and also with swing dancing. So I've got about 25 DVDs under my line called On Tap. So those are all there, and I'm all over Facebook and all that. But I'm getting to the 5,000, so you have to follow me.
There you have it. We've always followed you. Thanks so much for being on the show.
Thank you.
And we look forward to seeing your next adventure.
Okay, keep up the good work over there.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
All right, moving right along, we have one thing that excites us every year is, where am I? There I am. One thing that's, I was
You're
wearing
in
a yellow
San Francisco.
Shirt. I don't know what's going on. No caffeine in me, trust me. The Jazz Dance Film Festival announced its winners. We like this. We love this film festival. It brings us beautiful things like black coffee and One Girl and Two Boys and Killer Diller those great little clips.
Yeah, that's right, Killer Diller.
Yeah, you don't remember Killer Diller?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was cool, right?
It was really cool.
This year, they announced the winners of the latest competition, and we're going to talk about 3, 2, 1, the top three. You want to take number three?
So, rounding out in third place, we have I Charleston Warsaw.
And I Charleston.
It was performed by Shim Sham.
No, I Charleston.
Warszawski Swing. Okay, I'm not going to pronounce any of these Warsaw names correctly.
That's why Spuds gave this one to you.
Exactly.
But anyway, the idea was to gather all the videos of people dancing Charleston in the main places in their home cities. For this clip, we decided not only to show beautiful places, but also tell a story of a city that, despite being burned to the ground during World War II, was able to rebuild itself. Let's see what they're able to create.
Everyone loves a good Phoenix story. Oh. This one was so beautifully shot.
Yeah.
Nice use of black and white.
And incorporation of the music. Yeah. Really nice.
Beautiful.
Great work, you guys.
Beautiful. Really? Number two.
Yeah, Spuds. What's
number
two?
I'll take number two. Did you see bad words in there that I won't be able to pronounce? No. Number two, second place. This Brisbane, not Brisbane. Nobody said Brisbane, though, did they?
No.
I was already correcting no one. This Brisbane swing dance community got together to film a promotional video for their international swing dance event, Sunshine Swing. You're invited to their party and partake in the wonders of various forms of dance, including jazz, Charleston, Lindy Hop, solo blues, and cake?
Is the cake a lie?
That's the end of the video.
We're not going to watch the whole video.
I know, that's true. Okay. Let's watch a little bit of it. Spoiler alert! Hired a cake, hired a band, for goodness sake.
The bass player is just like, oh, there's these dudes dancing.
This is great right here. We'll show a little bit of this.
Right? How well done is that?
It's a bit creepy, though.
Hello.
Because they're all smiling.
Would you prefer if they were...
They should be sad.
But they programmed the gloves to play piano. It's cool.
All right. So, yeah, obviously, if I knew you were coming out, I'd have baked the cake. And, yes, at the end, the cake is a lie. Okay.
Stay to the end, kids.
Stay to the end.
Sorry, I ruined it.
No. You get number one, then. Shame on you.
Shame on me, I get number one. All right, so first place entry, drum roll. Why is there a drum roll? You probably, if you're on the internet too, you've probably seen this as well. It's Count the Swinger, an original tune by the Spicy Pickles.
Yay!
Yeah.
Spicy Pickles.
With some pretty great dancers in there too. So let's check that one out. Really cute too.
Aww.
Yeah, congratulations, Denver. Their scene is really doing things. Nicely done, guys.
Yeah, congrats.
All right, fine, take us out.
All right, thank you so much for watching Swing Nation episode, whatever this is, 59. Thanks once again to Rusty Frank for joining us.
So
seriously,
great.
Man.
Better and better interviews better. Every time.
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody. Okay, let me look at this.
So you can contact us and give us feedback about, you know, anything that you've seen on the show that you agree with, disagree with, you think we should cover this thing, let us know. Email us news@yehoodi.com.
Yes.
You can contact us on Facebook, Yehoodi. On Twitter, we are at Yehoodi, at Spuds, at Zuckerpunch, at Rickamatic. You should definitely subscribe to our channel on YouTube. Just search for Yehoodi. You can call us on the telephone at 201-984-SHOW. That's 201-984-7469. Thank you guys so much for joining us again this week.
Very
well done. We'll see
you. That's the way you take it out.
Like a boss!
Like a boss.
Like a mother effing boss.
Thanks for
watching. We'll see you next week. Thanks for joining.
See ya.
Down, pimp your stroll, put some jelly on that roll, Swing Nation.